So a few days ago, I happened to be in Jersey City and I grabbed a city bike and decided to ride around and also visit Hoboken and Weehawken, taking in most of the river. On the return, I decided I was going to cut through the neighborhoods of Hoboken. I hadn't been there in a few years. And I was just amazed at the amount of daylighting, the amount of parking that has been removed at the intersections to make it safer. And it's obvious to me that the city of Hoboken prioritizes intersection visibility over car parking. To be honest, over the last 5 years, many people had told me Hoboken was a good place where they were doing a lot of traffic calming, where they're trying to make better bicycle-friendly amenities. But to be honest, I was amazed when I saw it in person. And that there is no parking on all four corners so that you can safely see in each direction, whether you're a pedestrian, whether you're a bicyclist, whether you're a car driver. And it makes it safer because everything is more predictable. Now, this is one of my favorite shots. I just stood out in the middle of the street and panned around, and you could see one or two parking spaces on each side of the street have been taken back. Again, here's another overhead shot of that same intersection. Look how much visibility as we zoom out, how much you can see. There's no parking on any of those corners. Now, this was near a school. Look at the number of flexi posts they put in those zones not to park. That tells you don't park here. You know what I'm saying? In some of these places, they put bike share, and you can still see through bike share. So that's a good use of the space. This driver obviously could see the people about to cross, and he stopped. And again, this is just about everywhere. It did not seem like it was a few targeted places. And then here's one of my favorite shots. This woman's about to cross. Oh, she thinks the car's not gonna stop for her, but yes, it does, because it can see her. And here I come riding my bike up by a school, and you can see the crossing guards put out a couple cones to further emphasize the safety. But you can see there is a lot of visibility as you approach this intersection. This system works. There are some places where 8, 12, maybe even up to 16 spots, 16 parking spots have been removed at an intersection. And they've done this many different ways. You can see where they've painted yellow rectangular null zones saying you can't park here. But they've also done it with textured pavement. They've done it with cones. They've done it with bollards. They've done it with new curbs that obviously cost a lot of money. They've even begun to take back some of these spaces and filled them with greenery and bioswales. I actually came upon places where it looks like they're about to paint new ones, and other places where they're filling in solid curb extensions, making them permanent. You know, it makes a big difference when crossing the street to feel comfortable and reliably safe. You should be able to carry on a casual conversation with a friend, not having to fear that your right of way will be violated. So in closing, I'll say I didn't actually get to talk to anybody there. Again, this was a very spur of the moment trip, but it is obvious that in Hoboken, they are prioritizing pedestrians over car parking. I would really love to see this done in New York City on a grand scale. In New York City, it's typical that people park right up to the edge of the curb. Sometimes they leave their car into the crosswalk. And Mayor de Blasio, this would be something that'd be great to have as default practice in the Vision Zero toolkit. Make intersection visibility a priority. The reality is, this is something we should be doing in all of our cities.